Ron Prince, Tammy Colvin, and anniversary to Joseph and Amy Frex. The order of service today is Divine Service 3, without Holy Communion, and our intro for today is Psalm 85, verses 8 through 13. Now open up your hymnals to hymn number 901, Open Thou the Gates of Beauty.
Upon us, and has given his only Son to die for us, and for his sake.
forgives us all our sins. To those who believe on his name, he gives power to become the children of God, as promised them his Holy Spirit. He that believes and is baptized shall be saved. Grant this, Lord, unto us all.
Amen.
We'll turn now to an intro. It is Psalm 85. Psalm 85, verses 8 through 13. We'll say half verse by half verse. I will begin. Let me hear what God the Lord will speak.
For he will speak peace to his people, to his saints, but let him not turn back to all.
Surely his salvation is near to those who fear him.
That glory may dwell in our land.
Steadfast love and faithfulness meet.
Righteousness and peace exist against each other.
Faithfulness springs up from the ground.
And righteousness looks down from the sky.
Yes, the Lord will give what is good.
And our land will yield its increase.
Righteousness will go before him.
And he gives us the steps away.
But I'll continue with the glory of Patria, the top of page 186. Isaac shall sanctuaries of Israel shall be laid waste. And I will rise against the house of Jeroboam with the sword. And Ahaziah, the priest of Bethel, sent to Jeroboam, king of Israel, saying, Amos has conspired against you in the midst of the house of Israel. The line is not able to bear all his words. For thus Amos says that Jeroboam shall die by the sword, and Israel must go into exile away from his land. And Ahaziah said to Amos, O seer, go flee away from the land of Judah, and eat bread there, and prophesy there, but never again prophesy in Bethel, for it is the king's sanctuary, and it is the temple of the kingdom. And Amos answered and said to Ahaziah, I was no prophet, nor a prophet's son, but I was a herdsman and a dresser of sycamore figs. The Lord took me from following the flock, and the Lord said to me, go prophesy to my people Israel. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our epistle reading is from Ephesians chapter 1, verses 3 through 14. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. Even as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, we should be holy and blameless before him. In love, he predestined us for adoption as sons through Jesus Christ, according to the purpose of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace, of which he has blessed us in the beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses according to the riches of his grace, which he lavished upon us in all wisdom and insight, making known to us the mystery of his will, according to his purpose, which he has set forth in Christ. As a plan for the fullness of time, we unite all things to him, things in heaven and things on earth. In him we have ordained an inheritance, having been predestined according to the purpose of him who works all things according to the counsel of his will. So that we who are the first to hope in Christ might be to the praise of the Lord. In him you also, when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and believed in him, were sealed with the promised Holy Spirit, who is the guarantee of our inheritance until we acquire possession of it, to the praise of his glory. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
All rise for the gospel. Daughter came to him and he came be seated for the sermon hymn in 575.
have been chosen to have the triune God as our God. Our God who is above and before all other gods. Our God, one we can always trust in, count on, and depend on, no matter what. Today, tomorrow, and even for all eternity. In Jesus' name, amen. And
Morgan.